Historical simulation methods step on historical data in order to predict the future values of an unknown variable. The underlying assumption is that past historical data is the best predictor for the distribution of the unknown factors describing the variable. So, for example, under the historical simulation method, if option prices are described by interest rates and market volatility, the best way to estimate these two parameters would be to consider how interest rates and market volatility behaved historically. This is a different approach compared to the one used for Monte Carlo simulations, where an analyst chooses the distribution of the output variable and then tests for different realizations of the input variables describing the output variable. In terms of advantages and disadvantages of the two methods, we can say the following. On the positive side, using past data means that we are applying a more robust approach. It isn't up to the analyst's discretion to assume a specific type of distribution. However, the downside is that what occurred in the past may not be a good indicator of what will happen in the future. Moreover, another downside of historical simulations is that they don't allow us to perform what-if analysis, in which we simply test a new hypothesis and see what the impact would be if it was true. For example, in the case of Monte Carlo, we could simply apply a volatility that is 20% higher than the one we've applied previously, and see the results. We can't do that when applying historical simulations, though.